Sorry about that.
Yeah, it won't happen again. Thank you, drive-thru.
This week's episode of Hemp BCB is sponsored by...
Double the bowls, double the vapor, double the bliss through the haze.
Bonza Seeds, Hemp Beach's most trusted and reliable seed bank. Discreet worldwide shipping available.
Clear solutions for a clean pipe every time.
Couch Lock, our number one choice for our high enhancer. Alrighty, stoner fans.
Get your lighters out.
It's time to pack your bowls, bongs, roll your joints and blunts.
Let's get blazed.
It's time for Hemp Beach.
Hemp Beach TV, episode 283.
With your weekly dose of 420 entertainment, news, games, movies, and reviews.
Straight from your stoner news and television network.
Hemp Beach. I'm Max Toker.
And I'm Senor Chronic.
And the CEO slash pothead behind the camera as usual,
Scott.
What's up, man?
Not much.
What's going on? What have you been up to?
Just hanging out.
Yeah?
Pretty much.
Do anything exciting the past week or so?
No, not really. Right. Just get stoned like usual, you know. Not much to do. Been hanging out at Hemp Beach a lot. It's been hot as shit.
It gets hot at the beach.
Yeah.
It does.
Oh,
it's
man.
All those lights. All that sun exposure.
Yeah, I'm getting brown.
Getting? All right, so I guess it's on to topic number one.
Yeah.
I know I haven't done anything exciting this week. So,
there was a huge earthquake in California that just happened.
Oh, well, that didn't affect me at all.
Yeah. Well, hopefully our homies aren't okay.
I think the homies would be.
I hope your bomb didn't break.
I think they're fine.
A couple of them said that some of them shook to the edge of the shelf but didn't fall.
Oh, well, that's good news. That's good news.
That's terrifying, but good news that they didn't fall.
Nerve-wracking, I'm
yes,
sure.
Yes, very nerve-wracking.
I don't know what it's like to be in an earthquake. Never been in one.
Me either. I don't think it's that exciting. So
I've heard it's
easy hitting. Don't.
Oh, I'm well aware.
What? Don't clear it in one hit?
This shit's intense, man.
Is it?
It's mad intense. This is a good piece.
Good.
Medi-Cali piece.
But getting on to the first topic. What happened?
You just knocked a chunk and it's sitting on your.
It's not a chunk. It's ash. It looks. Oh, that's a stem, bruh.
Oh, that's not cool.
Tink.
You're gonna... He was about to go off on him about a bud, and it's just a damn stem. But it's okay, it's okay. Whoa.
Shit happens.
I know he's excited about this topic, and I'm excited about this topic. Marc Emery returns to Vancouver and urges supporters to legalize marijuana. I think that's awesome. You all right there, bud?
I'm fine. All right, so Marc Emery is back. He's been released from prison. He spent 4 years and 2 months in prison, and he has some interesting things to share. He says that in the American prison system, there's a ton of people about what do you say?
One in every
eight.
Yeah, one in every eight people person is in jail for life for drugs or doing drugs, specifically doing drugs. Excuse me. I think that's
bullshit.
That's just straight horse shit. I mean, if they're in there for weed, I think it's worse. But if they're in there for stronger shit, I mean, send them to rehab. I mean, you're going to send somebody to jail for 20 years for... being a crackhead or something? That's just fucked up.
Yeah.
But what are you going to do?
When you're caught in public being an alcoholic, you're just thrown in the drunk tank for a night. also known as the butt-naked cell.
I don't even want to know how you know that, but okay. We're going to talk
some
more about...
I've never spent any time in the butt-naked cell. But I know plenty of people who have.
I'm sure they're watching this episode. All right, moving on to Marc Emery. So a week ago, he returned across the border to Windsor, Ontario. So he made his first appearance in his home at his home in Vancouver. Well, that's good. I'm sure he was glad to go home.
Yeah, and he's automatic. Like, he's just immediately gotten out there, started pressing the flesh again. He's shaking hands.
He's pounding the pavement hard.
Babies, you know?
Yeah, pretty much.
he's still peddling for the legalization. Peddling is not the right word.
Yeah, that's not the right word. He's fighting for it.
What is the word I'm looking for?
Oh, whatever. Man.
But he's campaigning and doing things and stuff, and he's very happy with how his wife has run his business the past 4 years.
I like how he went to prison not knowing how to play the bass guitar and came out knowing how to play the bass guitar.
Well, yeah, I mean, prisoners are relatively friendly people.
Yeah, but I didn't know they'd allow anyone to have a bass guitar in there.
I mean, it all depends on which prison you go to.
I guess.
Did you know Conan O'Brien usually is, what do you call it, like warm-up sessions, usually with a guitar?
True.
Oh,
cool.
Like rehearsals, you know what I mean?
Yeah. I mean, I can dig it.
I just thought it was interesting.
I'm not saying it's not.
I think that's interesting.
But Marc Emery,
yeah,
since he's been out, has been smoking like 15 to 20 joints a day.
That is retarded.
I wish I could be that.
I wish I could too, but I think I'd be.
I could do that all the time.
I'd be.
I had a friend who went to prison in Oregon, and they told me that a joint in prison there is about this wide, and it's just super. It's normal length. It's just. Super, super skinny. It's like dust that they just roll up.
It's probably like $20 a joint.
And, yeah, and it's ridiculously expensive. And I asked him, I said, how do you know you even get high? How do you know you're just not, you know, lack of oxygen to the brain, just getting high on asphyxiation and inhaling smoke?
Emery talked about, you know, being in prison, and he did not have a bad thing to say about any of his experience in prison.
I mean, it's not a bad...
I mean, it's prison, but I'm guessing where he was, it was culpable.
Like, if you stay away from all the gangs and stuff, and you're not already gang-related, you're probably just gonna, you know, I mean, do your
Which
time and get
the fuck
out.
Which side do you think he went to, the Bloods or the Crips?
I think everybody was like, this dude's got some of the best weed in the world. I'm going to go hang out with him.
Yeah, right?
I've been to his shops.
Bet you have.
Oh, man.
But now they're talking about October 19th.
No, it's October 9th.
I thought it was
19th or the 9th?
19th.
Oh, okay, 19th, 2015, yeah.
Yeah, October 19th, 2015 is going to be legalization day. They're trying to get all this shit going on, and it's all in Canada, right?
Believe it or not, we've actually covered his whole story from beginning till end.
Yeah, I remember. We've been covering it.
The Prince of Pot
accepted. Marc Emery?
Yes, he accepted a 5-year jail term for the selling of his seeds.
So his seed?
Not his seed.
Oh.
His seeds.
He's got seeds, like weed seeds that are, you know, tasty, delicious, awesome, Acapulco fucking kind of shit.
Acapulco gold, man.
Maui.
That Michoacan. But that's way, funny. But yeah.
Totally pleaded guilty, finally, to selling millions of pot seeds all over America.
52 years old.
52, the DEA is pissed. He's a white-collar criminal. He's going to a federal prison. He's going to be fine.
Well, yeah, he's going to be in there.
If you're going to go to jail, that's the way to go to jail.
Yep. 5 years ago, it says, is when, you know.
Yeah, he's been ducking and dodging for a long time.
And the offenses that he got, or that he committed, I'm sorry, they have a minimum fucking sentence of 5 years. So it's like, dude, no matter what plea or deal you get, you're still going to do 5 years no matter what.
Marc Emery
is going to jail for 5 years for selling seeds and providing America with the fruit of our labor.
Yeah, good job, man.
Good job. Thanks for doing it all the time you have been. And
hope to one day smoke with you.
Yeah, hit us up when you get out of jail, dude.
We'll come up Canada.
Yeah, we'll come pick you up.
You selling weed to everybody in America, even if it's in seed package form.
Yep, that's awesome.
Yeah, we've been around so long, he actually went in jail and came back up.
Wow. Ta-da. But that's like, he went to prison for seeds, right? Who goes to prison for seeds? That's terrible.
Yes, it's the American government.
That's terrible.
Charges.
Seeds.
And then his own government turned on him and extradited him.
Yeah, it's a bunch of bullshit. But anyways, on to some more bullshit. And topic number two. There's an ad war looming over Florida medical marijuana.
I don't even want to talk about this, but we have to.
It's ridiculous. These ads that they've been playing medical marijuana.
Have you seen the cookie ad?
I have, and now that you've mentioned it.
That's just wrong.
Yeah.
You're right, dumb.
It smells pretty nasty, so I'm going to...
You're right.
Oh. Yeah, I mean... That's why we wear black, man. And that wasn't a gang reference at all.
I don't know, where are we? You're already representing right now.
Oh. Yeah.
Well.
What are you going to do?
I mean.
Gang colors, gang symbols.
I don't know about symbols.
Juggalo? Action
Man's a symbol.
It's not a symbol.
Oh man.
The Juggalos are mad at you.
It's yeah.
It's not a gang symbol is what I mean.
Oh, I meant just a symbol.
It's not a gang
symbol. It's like an ICP symbol.
Well yeah, it's the symbol for their record label. This is Beat again.
Oh, okay. Always ends on you.
Yeah. It always starts on you. Yeah.
Well, apparently these burst of ads are going to be coming real soon to TV screens in Florida. So they're going to be showing ads like that cookie ad that I was talking about, where you see a young couple walking down the road and he's got a marijuana edible in his back pocket and it says date rape cookie. Really?
Can we show the ad? You think?
I could put it up there.
We'll show you the ad.
Yeah.
I think I've already did.
All right, well, there was the ad, and that happened, and it's bullshit. Bullshit.
On the bag, date rape cookie.
Yeah, that's like, just like, really, guy? You're really going to do that?
That's just stupid. It's
could be a little more discreet.
Poor form. Republicans in Florida, you need to, I got a headache.
He went from Republicans in Florida to, I got a headache.
Yeah, because it feels like I just got rocked in the head, man. Ow.
So right, he's hurt right now.
Fuck Florida Republicans and being dicks about things. Go liberal and vote for free weed. I mean, legal weed. I mean, medical weed.
That is great. He's like free weed. Legal weed. Medical weed. So now that you've covered all three aspects.
Yeah, the weed. Vote for the weed. Make it happen. Be happy. Get a smile on.
Well, someone here on our next topic's been having a little too much fun.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Jackie Chan's son has been arrested in Beijing with more than...
Say third topic.
Third topic!
What do you want us to do?
Transition! Man? Hey, segues are weird. Jackie Chan's son arrested in Beijing with more than 3.5 ounces of marijuana.
Well, over there, 3.5 ounces is like us having, 3 pounds here and you're walking around with it.
I mean, 3.5 ounces here is like.
I mean, yeah, it's a lot of weight. In certain places.
A felony.
Yeah.
He's looking at a lot of jail time and.
I read.
Possibly a hefty
not
fine.
In this article, but I read in a different article that he was facing life imprisonment.
Jesus Christ. Like, life in prison for 30 points?
It's some serious shit in China. They don't fuck around with that stuff. And they just recently did a sting where they fucking arrested 42 people in the entertainment and performance business in China.
No, I like how these agencies are boycotting all these artists and entertainers if they do drugs, if they test positive for any drugs at all.
That's ridiculous. That is absolutely ridiculous. It's their money. Let them get fucked up if they
want. For real. That's their problem.
All right, well,
yeah.
All these stories and more can be found at our website at www.hempbeach.tv.
Alrighty, people. It's time to pay some bills, and now a word from our gracious sponsors. The Haze is the first and only dual bowl vaporizer on the market. It can use dried herbs, wax, and oils interchangeably. It comes with all-purpose cans for pre-packing and storing all materials. It uses a strong, long-lasting external lithium-ion battery. Features an LED temperature setting display, has four different temperature settings, uses advanced technology to heat on demand, built with an enhanced heat exchange mechanism for a cool vapor output.
Bonza Seeds, the most trusted and reliable pick-and-mix seed bank. Get free feminized seeds with every order. Worldwide, ultra-discreet and reliable shipping. Hundreds of amazing quality marijuana strains available. Amazing customer service. We love our customers. VIP weekly offers and promos sent to all customers. Use the coupon code HEMPBEACH to get 10% off your order. Find them at www.bonzaseeds.com.
Alrighty, and those were the sponsors.
Excuse me. Those were our sponsors, indeed. On to Max's nerdy shit.
Nerdy shit.
Nerdy shit. All right, so amid some things that I saw this week and some fucking articles that I read on the internets, first of all, I saw this thing for Baby X, which is this ridiculous program.
Awesome.
It's an animated baby. And it's learning.
Like the dancing baby?
No, like much better. Like it looks. No. It looks like a video feed of a real baby.
Yeah, pretty much.
And like it can react. It can get bored. It's an AI, and it's learning things. And they're teaching it words and stuff. They've taught it how to play Pong. It's having a good time. It follows the shit on the screen. Like Pong comes up on top of it, in front of it. Like so, you're playing like either side, and it follows the ball on the screen.
It's That's awesome.
Fucking creepy, dude. Like, it is so fucking creepy. Another thing that I saw that was really interesting was windowless jets.
Windowless jets?
Windowless jets. Now, what this is basically it's
a jet with no windows.
A jet with no windows.
And on the inside, there's a bunch of screens, like big LCD screens, you know, like along the sides and the top, and they have camera feeds on the outside that would feed to you the entire panoramic view of where you're flying into and stuff.
Nice.
Which is really cool and shit, but you know, like, I don't know, I thought of some really weird things right off the bat. Like, there's other cool things you can do with it. They can play movies and dim it and whatnot. And, like,
no way.
Having no windows on the plane makes it lighter and easier to, like, more streamlined to nice. Make and everything. And,
That's cool. No, windowless jets. LCD screens.
Ridiculous.
With cameras.
Now, in the world that we're in nowadays, though, with all these hackers doing things and shit like that, a hacker could
they can watch easily, Hemp Beach while flying.
Well, no, they could hack the fucking system and make it look like you're flying into some other place, wherever you think you're flying into, hijack the plane and fly it somewhere else. Or the government, if they want to ship you off into fucking like concentration camps, they can fucking do that. And you'll never be the wiser.
Oh, man.
You know what I mean?
They're trying to fly us off.
You think you're going to Paris, you get out of the plane, and you're like...
fucking, in Iraq?
Not necessarily in Iraq, but like on some fucking desert isle and some prison camp, and you don't know what the fuck's going
on. In the middle of nowhere?
Yeah, in the middle of fucking nowhere. You'd be in the middle of the desert. Who fucking knows? You could be in Malaysia.
Malaysia. Nice.
somewhere in Indonesia.
No, don't want to go there.
Said endo.
Endo?
In your endo.
Endo. So last weekend, Sony's PlayStation Network came under a denial of service attack yet again.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Well, I mean...
It was down last Sunday morning until 10 a.m. when they fixed it. But they had announced the past that they were going to have scheduled maintenance on Monday. And the service...
Sony does seem to get hacked a lot.
Jesus.
Hey, it's only time until Xbox does. Or at least becomes public that it has.
This is true. Well,
has Xbox service ever been down?
Like, it goes down for maintenance, but that's just maintenance, and it's like scheduled, and they let you know when it's gonna happen.
Nice. Alrighty.
Alright, well, that's all I got for nerdy shit this week. Always support Hemp Beach by supporting our sponsors!
Clear Solutions has developed a custom formulated patent pending 5-in-1 cleaner designed to remove organic tars and resins from your dirty glass, metals, tools, clothes, and hands. I know I've said a mouthful, but let me elucidate. It's so easy that Clear Kryptonite cleans in just 3 simple steps. 1. First, pour enough clear kryptonite into your dirty glass apparatus to allow it to coat all areas. Return all excess into clear kryptonite bottle for reuse. Next, allow the clear kryptonite to soak for at least 20 minutes. It may require more time to soak depending on magnitude of buildup. If you haven't already, this may be a great time to walk the dog. 3. Finally, rinse with warm water. That's it. Clear Kryptonite will leave your glass looking and smelling like it's never been used. You can pre-order it online today at www.clearsolutions.com.
All right, those were our sponsors.
Yeah.
And speaking of sponsors, I would like to...
El Senor Chronico!
What?
What?
What happened?
I don't know. He froze. Weird. All right. So I'd like to make a little shout out to one of our sponsors. I told you I was going to do this.
I don't know what shout out. This is random and spontaneous.
Random and spontaneous.
Gee, what a crazy random happenstance.
Please tell me about what you're about to say.
I took and cleaned my Medi-Cali bong with Clear Solutions. And man, the bottle says I was in a hurry. The bottle says to let it sit for an hour, and I really wanted to hit my bong. So I let it sit for 20 fucking no, not even 20 minutes. I let it sit for like 5 minutes. The whole process took me 20 minutes. It came out clean as a whistle. It was dirtier than this thing. This thing's not that dirty though.
No, it's not.
But it was mad dirty. It was dirty as fuck. I got it clean real quick with that Clear. I love that shit. I don't know what they do, but they know what they're doing.
Yeah. Just all keep right. Doing it.
Tell them how to get a hold of us.
Oh, our contact info. That's always nice. You can email us at hempbeachtechbros.net.
You can check us out on Facebook, like our shit.
Facebook.com.
Be our friend, subscribe and shit. Go to facebook.com/hempbeachtv.
While Facebook's still available.
While it's still available.
Why wouldn't it be available? Facebook's always going to be available. It's here to stay.
Just in case it's gone in the future.
MySpace is gone. Fuck
yeah.
Hey, if we were around when MySpace was around, now it's gone.
Yeah, and you know what? Before MySpace, I had a dilly. But, you never had a dilly?
No.
Oh, man. I used to be all up in the social network. The dilly was cool as fuck. I had it before I turned... No? All
right. You can subscribe. Our videos at YouTube at youtube.com/hempbeach.
Comment on them shit.
Yeah, lots of feedback.
Follow us on Instagram at instagram.com/hempbeachtv.
Or you can just go directly to our website, www.hempbeach.tv. I'm just tired. Would you like me to yell? Do you want me to yell at the people? Why do I have to yell at the people?
Do it.
I'm not yelling.
I executive order, dude. Next one, go.
People aren't going to like me yelling.
Yeah. The director.
Oh, man. Send us a tweet on Twitter.
That's not I'm not going to scream.
Fucking do it. Fucking
you scream.
Do it.
Look, we don't have the... Yeah.
Why am I going to
do it?
Because.
Why?
Because he's not going to pay you if you don't.
Do it.
Catch 22 of that is he's not going to pay you if you do. But.
Oh, man. I'm not going to yell, but I am going to tell the people to send us a tweet on Twitter at HempBeatsTV.
And hashtag that shit, HempBeatsNation.
I'm Senor Chronic.
I'm Max Toker.
Peace out from HempBeats.